Ready now, Delta.
I can't wait to meet her, Amanda. Don't worry. It will be like the old days.
Tell her I love her.
I will.
Hurry, they need you.
Celebrate a harvest. Not one that grows from this land, but from a courtroom of brick and mortar. One man who volunteered his time to stand for us has saved not only our farms, but our dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, I am most honored to present to you, my friend, our champion, Mr. Brad Fairmont.
Thank you, all. Thank you.
Thank you. No, that's all right. Thank you. Thank you, Martin. Thank you all. Thank you. But there's nothing profound or complex about my decision to represent you. There's no hesitation and certainly no regret. I did it simply because it was the right thing to do. You know, it's a sad fact of life that as long as there are good, hardworking people who must struggle to create a better life for their families, armed with only the sweat of their labor and their will to survive, there will always be bad people, unscrupulous and greedy, and unfortunately with money and influence, who will try to wrangle that which does not rightfully belong to them. But today, the guys who tried to cheat you, they're history.
Thank you. Thank you, Brad. Thank you so much. As you can see, the man is eloquent. Maybe a little long-winded. But you know, that's how he won the case. He starved the competition to death. And so are you probably starving to death. So we want to thank everybody. We're going to have this great food from Juan Lechin. A música maestro, a comer todo mundo! nice meeting.
That was great.
Martin.
Hi.
Martin, yeah, you remember Kayla?
Hey, it's good to see you again.
I don't know her.
Look how big, huh?
Oh, Dad, don't look at me. Come on.
Thank you. Hi, baby.
Hi. I'm so proud that I went up there and did that.
Oh, thanks. Talk.
No, go away. Davi's occluding again. Pull over.
Kayla! Are you finished your homework yet?
Almost.
Come on, Sarah.
Empty bottles of over-the-counter pesticides. Making the discovery, burger magnate and noted...
Tissue. I said tissue. Do you have any idea what a paper towel will do to a nail? There. Hey, are you just gonna leave that there? What's with you? Every day, it's like a total hell with you. Nothing but attitude. You trying to get me to quit? Is that it?
No.
All right. And don't forget to clean the kitchen. You know your dad likes it clean.
Hurry up, he's up ahead, Sarah.
David!
Sarah! Run! I'm fine, Sarah.
Hello?
How's my girl?
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, baby. Look, I'm rushing. I'm really trying to get out of here. Is everything okay?
Yeah.
What's wrong, baby?
Nothing.
Honey, are you okay?
I'm good.
Honey, I'm sorry I'm late, okay? I'm on the way. I'm on the way right now.
Did Tammy clean the kitchen like I told her?
Well, yeah.
Okay. I'll see you soon, okay? Bye, baby.
Bye.
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 I love you. Bye.
Love you too. Bye.
The hearing starts right at 9 tomorrow. Don't be late.
Trust me, with a merger this size, I won't be late. I promised Kayla I'd be home an hour ago.
Better make sure you take the garbage out and bring me a cup of juice on your way out.
Hello?
I think I could use some help. I snagged more than I can chew. No, wait. I don't chew. I mean, bite. I'm just talking about a piece of wood.
What are you? Are you a dog?
Man's best friend.
No way. Oh my gosh, something's caught on your leg.
Oh, it looks worse than it is. I could use some water.
Water?
Ice cold, if you have it. Just take the lid from the pail. It's an old trick. It goes with lawn sprinklers. Just do me one favor and don't take it from a toilet. Okay? I really appreciate this, my dear.
Are you okay?
I'm fine, Sarah. Thank you.
Let's see. We got him.
Still there. That's a good sign.
Oh, thank you.
You were really talking to me just now, weren't you?
What's the big deal? It's not like I'm driving a car or something.
You just did it again. How can you? I mean, dogs don't talk.
Maybe it's just that people don't listen.
I guess you do. This is just too awesome.
Kayla! Your dad's here!
Don't I have to go? Just promise me you'll wait here, okay?
Don't worry. You're not about to lose me, Kayla.
So awesomely awesome.
Dr. Haas, that we lost our chance at the Nobel Prize. I mean, how long do you think he would keep us around after that, Sarah?
David, look.
Now what?
Dad? Hmm? You like dogs, right?
Honey, we've already talked about this.
I know, but what if we found one that was really special?
Baby, they're all special, every one of them, you know, but it's a lot of responsibility.
What if he was really smart? Like, he could take care of himself.
I mean, you're not home all day, right? I'm not home all day. That poor guy, he's going to be all alone out back. That's not fair.
But what if he could understand us when we told him when we'd be back?
Dogs aren't like people. They don't understand things like that.
Yes, they do.
Honey, Saturday, I'm going to take you to build it there. And we're going to buy you that stuffed puppy that you like. You know, the one with that cute little baseball uniform and that number 9 on him?
Wow, another stuffed dog.
Don't be too long with the homework, okay?
Just go a little slower here, Sarah. It's hard to see.
It's okay. Easy.
Oh, wipe the napkin, as they say. Thanks, Kayla.
What was that? Did you hear that, Sarah? Right around here, I heard something.
Two 2774. Right. That sure isn't much of a name.
I hear some people find their work a lot easier. They just turn you into a number.
Ouch.
Yeah.
I bet you sure could talk a lot louder without your throat being hurt. What happened?
Well, it's all very foggy.
Some kind of surgery, huh?
Looks that way.
How about Oswald? For your name.
Oswald. That sounds a little stuffy to me.
You're right. That's stupid. You don't look anything like an Oswald.
I mean, if I had a name, I'd like it to be different, wonderful, and mysterious. Something that would turn my head when you call me.
Magic. Magic.
Magic.
This one time at SeaWorld, I heard a seal call my name. I told my dad, but he just gave me that, you know, that look.
Yeah, they do that sometimes.
It's going to get colder tonight. If you want, you can come inside.
I wouldn't want to get you in any trouble.
It'll be okay. We'll go into my room.
I guess I better wipe my feet.
Come on.
Well, first things first. I guess you have to meet everyone.
I'd love to.
This is Jimmy Jerry, my very first. Jimmy Jerry's a little grumpy.
Yeah, seems a little
yeah,
stuffy.
Polar, my polar bear, kind of get along, but not always. Now we have Bubba, Hatches, and Sandy. And over here we have... Valerie, Leo, and Johnny.
Oh, look at this. Wait a minute. Hold it. Look at this, Sarah. Look at this. This is him. Okay, he's around here somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Do you see everything in color or black and white?
Oh, I see everything just like you.
I knew it. Dreams. Do dogs have dreams?
Not only in our sleep, but in our hearts, just like people.
What is it with the mailman? I mean, why do you guys go nuts?
I guess it's just safer than chasing the dog catcher.
What about feelings? Do dogs really feel things like people do?
Oh, yeah. We feel plenty.
Loving someone, or feeling happy, or...
sad, yeah, like you miss somebody.
That's too bad. I don't like that much myself.
No one does, Kayla.
Hi, I'm Sarah Westcott, and this is Dr. Ortero.
Yes, good evening.
Is everything okay?
Yes. We're from Genevet in Valencia. We're so sorry to be bothering you this late.
Veterinary medicine?
Research, mostly.
Well, we're a facility of advanced medical technology, and we serve the needs of both humans and animals.
Yes, but...
yeah, we're looking for a dog. He's a very big dog. He's a cross between a St. Bernard...
St. Bernard and a lab.
I haven't seen any dogs tonight.
Oh, my God, I can't... That's dog. A Van Flausen, isn't it? Sarah, I have a shirt. Just, you know, you've got wonderful taste. Really wonderful.
Great. Anyhow, the dog is yes, really
we,
big.
Yes,
and...
we think this dog is very sick and it needs medication.
I don't know.
Yes, we think he might be suffering from the very moment, possibly crawling into the dark spot to die. Maybe even in your backyard. Do you mind if we have a look-see?
Your neighbors have been kind enough to already let us look in their backyard, so...
No, go ahead. You have to go around the side there. The gate's unlocked.
Lights.
Kayla.
You
got the flashlight.
Thank you.
You remember when I told you some people would rather give you a number than a name?
Yeah, boy.
Well, you look at it.
No dog around here.
Wasn't too much of
an inconvenience for you.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll keep my eyes open.
Great, that'd be good.
No, Jack. Don't cast it tomorrow.
I mean, I'll go without sleep if I have to. I'm going to find that dog. Well, it's funny you should say that. That's exactly what I did. I obtained a signed order from Dr. Haas. Yes, we'll autopsy that dog.
Autopsy? I mean,
that's right. I want to find out what's going on now. I mean, she wants to study the dog the rest of its natural life. I mean, who has time for that, really? Well, I'll let you know. Yeah, of course I will.
I'm sorry. I hope I didn't scare you. Huh. You haven't seen any doggies around here tonight, have you? You sure? Hmm. Well, it's very important that if you do see the dog, you let your daddy know, because we have to take care of it, okay? Okay, very nice.
You feeling okay?
I'll be fine.
Well, we're out of options, David. I'm gonna call on Genevieve.
I think that's a good idea, Sarah. You need my phone?
No, I got mine.
I'm gonna go sit down for a minute.
Okay.
I won't ever let them get you. I promise.
Well, it's about time. Now maybe we'll get somewhere, Sarah. Hello, gentlemen. I took you boys to meet donuts.
Protocol.
Dr. Westcott witnessed my instructions. Now, this dog represents a great deal of investment for Genevieve Industries. But no harm is to come to the animal in any form during captivity. You understand?
Be careful of his throat. He just had surgery.
Sarah, let me handle this here, please. Now, Sergeant, should the animal be harmed, you'll be held personally accountable to Genevieve Industries. You acknowledge that?
Yes, sir.
Well, I hope so. I know chemical, Sergeant. You'll ruin all my data. Now, have your men check these houses. This dog is here. I know it.
Find this animal. Consider it top protocol.
Kayla, I brought you some dessert.
Oh, thanks, Dad. Just a minute.
Can I come in, honey?
Just hang on, Dad. Just give me a second. Just 1 minute. Okay. Come in, Dad.
That took a while. Chocolate chip cookies. Nice and warm.
Perfect. Milk?
Milk with cookies? You know, we really have to rethink this stuffed animal thing, okay?
Dad, I heard those people at the door. What did they want?
Oh, they're doctors, honey. They're looking for a sick dog.
Do you think if he comes into our backyard, we can keep him?
Honey.
But what if they want to kill him?
Kayla, you're not making sense. I'm going to steal one of your cookies, okay?
Dad, come on. Let's go play the downstairs game.
Honey, I'm tired. I worked all day.
You never want to play anymore.
Oh, honey. Okay, I have a great game. Are you ready? Tickle, I can play. I can play just like you. How's it? You want to play? You want to play?
Jenkins, this is command. What's your 20?
I'm on North of Sierra Highway.
If you pick up anything outside, radio me immediately.
Nothing yet.
This dog's Houdini. If he's out here, I don't see him.
Oh. Light. I think I drank too much water. Seems where he's a friendly. Guess I'll have to use one outside. Disgusting. I sure hope this door is a squeaker. There we go. Yes, sir. Okay. Oh.
Guys, we got something.
Roger that.
We have a sighting northeast quadrant. All teams converge in that area.
Got it.
Over it out, guys.
Got it. Blue team, heading out. ETA, 2 minutes.
On my way.
The house in the middle of the block.
Uh-oh. Looks like I'm being cornered from both sides.
I think we got something.
Okay. Come on, come on, come on.
Blue team, moving in the house. 4 minutes. Proceeding.
Anybody in there?
You guys still searching?
Yes, sir, we are. Sorry, sir. Sorry to disturb you.
Have a good night, sir.
Sorry. False alarm, guys.
Oh, baby, give me a hug. I love you.
Love you too. Oh. Come on. Let's go. Bye, Dad. Love you. All right. The bus is going to be here any second. I've got something on each and every one of you. And if any of you guys blab that I did school today, I'm going to start talking. Got it?
Okay, so we're gonna continue searching from the air. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna cover the hills to the north and to the west.
Son.
Okay?
Ma'am. Eat or something.
Look, you guys, I know everyone's really tired, but he's out here somewhere.
We're
and we have to find him before the sun does.
Well,
right. Will do.
My dad sort of doesn't want me up here, so I doubt he'll have a check. Besides, I don't know where else to keep you.
Here, take this one.
Thanks. That was too close a call for me last night. I almost, like, had a heart attack. I thought for sure he was gonna find...
What? What is it?
Oh, my gosh. What made you pick this one?
I don't know. Just picked it.
Actress Amanda Sinclair will be filming her new television movie on location in Agua Dulce this week.
Oh, how nice.
Amanda Sinclair uses her maiden name, Amanda Francis, whenever she produces. Amanda Francis.
Yeah?
That was my mother's last name before she married my dad.
Really? You know, it could be a coincidence, Kayla.
I give him 3 weeks. He is so dumping her. You should see him. No? Why? I can bring some stuff. Yeah. What do you want? One bottle, two bottles?
Well, we've definitely got the same kind of eyebrows. And the chin. My gosh, the chin. It's almost exactly the same.
Kayla, sometimes we see things the way we want them to be.
It makes complete sense. Dad said Mom was an artist.
Now he's not gonna know. Please, this guy, he has this wine that was like an anniversary present from his wife years ago. He never touches it. No, it's really good. I got smashed on it last Saturday.
Anyway, I was telling my friend Ariana about how my dad always said how much my mom loved me. That's when Trey Murphy, the evil creep, said that if she loved me so much, she wouldn't have left me.
Oh, she loves you, Kayla. Very much.
Thank you, Magic.
Oh, my sweet girl.
You guys did this area here, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we took it.
That quadrant? You took it?
Your dad is gonna worry like a turkey on Thanksgiving.
He's going to worry, but this will help.
Another wonderful meal on a plastic plate. This family, they live like they're camping out or something. Oh, it's okay. Yeah. Well, I'll see you when I get there.
Coast is clear.
I don't know, Kayla. I got a bad feeling about going this way.
What is it?
Good girl. You found my dog.
Get out of here! Run, Kayla!
Excuse me, what do you think you're doing?
Sarah! They're going back around the house!
Hey, who the hell are you people?
It's the team.
Anybody got a visual?
No, we're still looking, sir.
Okay, split up. Search every backyard in the street.
All right, everybody, stand out.
I'd like to see them fit through there.
I know a shortcut to the bus stop. Come on.
As long as we get away from here. I never want to go through that tube again. You just stay close to me, Kayla. I won't let anything happen to you.
That was never on our term sheet. We never discussed an earnout. It doesn't make any sense according to your revenue projections.
That's because our revenue projections didn't include the ad buy we just closed. And frankly, with the type of traffic our site gets, we should be asking for more on the earnout schedule.
More?
Look, we're all colleagues here, okay? I promise you there's a workaround for this. We can increase the shares. We can put caps on the earnouts if you like, if we really need to, all right? But we've come way too far. Now, Diane, we've come way too far to make this the deal breaker.
Mr. Fairman, it's about Kayla.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
We have to reschedule.
Does this go to Agua Dulce?
Sure does. How many?
Just one. Or two if we have to pay for him.
What is that?
It's my dog.
Honey, that dog's the size of a small horse. Is there an adult traveling with you?
Well, no. Not now. But I'm going to see my mother. She's in Agua Dulce.
Dear, this isn't Dumbo's circus train. It's a passenger bus. And I can't possibly expect the other customers to share space with that big furry thing.
He's not a thing. He's a dog. And if that's the way it's gonna be, I wouldn't want to ride your dirty old bus anyway. Come on, Magic.
Moron.
Who needs a stupid bus?
Yeah.
Fairmont, Detective Davis.
Thanks for coming.
My pleasure.
I got here as fast as I could.
If Agua Dulce is a half an hour by bus, how long could it be to walk?
Too long.
Come on.
Well, that's a few more miles at my age.
I will, Diane, as soon as they know anything. I mean, tell them what's happening. Make them postpone it.
I'm going to have our search team coordinate with police efforts.
If you want to put the team under their control, that's your prerogative. I just think it's a big mistake.
Okay.
Just don't expect me to stop looking on my own.
A long time ago, I lived with a little girl just like you. In fact, you remind me of her more than you can know. Then she grew up, had a little girl of her own, then went to heaven. That sweet place up there where miracles are manufactured for some of the good folks down here.
Wait, here.
You know, it wouldn't surprise me at all if meeting you in your backyard wasn't just that, a miracle from up there. Great stuff, this water.
I was cleaning the kitchen. Mr. Fairmont likes the kitchen clean when he gets home.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and anything else comes to mind, please don't hesitate to call. How recent is this photo? A couple months. Okay, Mr. Vermont, it's going to take me a little time to get her into the system, but I'll give you a call in a couple hours. And if you can think of anyone she might think of as her mother, please call me.
I will.
You know, I don't know what she could be thinking.
I know it's difficult, but don't beat yourself up over this.
I hope you're right.
You know, in the note, it says here that she's going to come back soon, so we'll get her. We'll find her.
Actually, do you have any idea where she was hiding the dog?
No.
It would be good for us to probably look, see if there's anything there could help us.
No, I didn't even know the dog was here. But well, we could look. I mean, we could.
Very good idea, Sarah. Yes, we need to find this animal, you see. It's very important to us.
So how'd you end up in the pound?
Could have been destiny.
At least it's good that she's giving the dog some nourishment. That's a good thing there. Would you look at this? I can't believe it. I haven't seen one of these in years. My grandfather had one of these. Yeah, of these old addicts, you never know what you're going to find, you know?
No, please, don't touch that. Don't touch that. This, it belonged to her mother.
Oh, please. Oh, I'm sorry.
You don't think there's anything in there that could help us?
No, she never touched that.
But what makes you so sure?
She's my daughter.
People don't always see miracles until they stop to think how something might have turned out. For instance, what if that Dr. Ortero got a hold of me before I found you?
I hate people sometimes.
Yeah, there are plenty of good ones, too. Well, I remember one time...
What is it?
Did you hear that? There's something over there. Sure smells familiar.
Get out of here!
Run, Kayla!
It's Brad. Detective Davis. The bus stop. Via Princesa.
Oh, well, don't say.
That's all she said? She didn't give you a street address or anything?
That's what I told the police already. I heard her say to the bus driver she wanted to go to Agua Dulce because her mother was there.
Please, try to remember. Was she alone? Did somebody try to give her a ride?
Not that I saw.
Come on.
Look, at least we have a direction.
Look, what we need is a topo map. I need to check all the trails she could have taken.
No, I have GPS in the van. It's better than any map.
Oh, no. Oh.
What?
That's Kayla's backpack.
Hey, what are you doing?
Is this yours?
Yeah.
Where'd you get this?
I found it.
Where?
Over there.
What's the matter with you, buddy? Tell me where she is.
I don't know.
Where is she?
Now be careful.
She knows where Kayla is. You tell me where she is, I'll help me God.
She went down the train tracks with that dog.
I didn't touch her. I just took the money. That's all. Hey.
What's going on?
He robbed my daughter. She's only 10.
All right, calm down.
You call Detective Davis, LAPD. You call me, tell him Kayla Fairmont. You got it? Kayla Fairmont.
There wasn't anything I needed in my pack anyway. I won't really even need money once we get to my mother.
Probably needed that money more than you did, Kayla. I need to get a little shut-eye. How about you?
Yeah, we could use a little rest. We chose the perfect spot.
Nothing like an afternoon nap.
Brad, wait! Wait! Look! That road goes right along the tracks down there. Let me just radio David, tell him to bring the van around. Okay, David! David, come in!
You see those white puffy kind of clouds up there? That's where angels live. Sometimes, if I squint just right, I sort of see them. Do you really think there could be angels up there?
Don't you think angels could do the job a whole lot better if they were down here?
I don't know. I never really thought of it that way. What are angels' job?
Well, some play harps and trumpets. And we've got a few singers, too. But some are guardians, and their job is to help you when you're feeling sad.
Magic? What if it's not her? I didn't used to think about her that much. But just all of a sudden, it's like... I have to know.
I will.
Kayla!
Uh-oh.
That's my dad.
Thinking it would be better if we went another way, Kayla.
I can't believe it. I can't believe he'd bring them.
There she is. Kayla!
We've got to get out of here.
Let's hurry it up, Sarah. Let's hurry it up.
Come on, Magic. We have to hurry. Come on!
Kayla!
Come on, Magic, run! Let's go!
Hurry up.
Kayla!
Sarah! We can go around this way, shorter.
Careful, Kayla. Watch your feet. Watch where you're stepping.
Ah!
Kayla, get up. You have to get up, honey.
I can't. Hey. Stop,
Dad.
Get away from my dog! No, Daddy, we're gonna kill him.
No,
we
gotta
cut him up into pieces.
No, that's ridiculous.
What is she talking about?
He's attacking.
Come on, Magic.
Much too important to sit on, all right? The quickest way to find out what happened is to open up the door.
Destroy him? No, as long as I am in charge of this project, no one is gonna hurt him.
You know what? You take it up with Dr. Hatch. He gave me his approval 2 days ago.
You can't do this.
Well, it's done. It's done, Sarah.
Kayla!
This means nothing to me. Pass has to answer to me. Okay, it's been my protocol on this from the beginning.
Now, come on, Sarah. Just where did you bump him? If all those research animals you killed could talk, they'd probably call you Dr. Death.
I just don't know what's come over you lately. You sound like you're coming down with a case of smoke.
I mean, really, how many did you put down here, Julia? 2,000, 3,000?
It wasn't like that. I did it humanely. And I only put down dogs when there was no hope.
Hope? Hope belongs in religion, Sarah. Not science. I don't know what happened.
Doctor, I have to get my cell phone. It's in your van. My phone.
No one's getting away in the van but myself. Just keep away. You just keep away.
What are you doing? What is this?
Just stand down. Keep away.
David!
Keep away!
Have you lost your mind, David? God. Wait, just hold on. Brad. I have something.
That was too close for my comfort. Let's hurry away from here. You know, Kayla, sometimes you take a journey in life and you never know what you're gonna find. I have to admit, this whole thing sounded a lot better in the attic. I sure don't remember anything about dodging trains. And your dad. Talk about spunk.
When we get to Uncle Joe's, I'll call him. I just know if I can explain it to him, he'll understand.
I read every book there was on single parenting. Nothing prepares you for this, nothing.
Did you ever think about getting her own dog?
Dog.
Well, yeah, I mean, the companionship, it might be just the thing to help her through all this. Sure helped me. I was the painfully shy type when I was little. And my only real friends were the neighborhood strays.
Your dad seemed like a good guy.
He wouldn't let them hurt you. He's really a nice man. Kind of like my best friend, actually. I just wish he didn't get together with those people.
I tell you this, I was never lonely. And I swore someday I would try to give back what they gave me. course, it ended up being just a little more complicated than that. Still, having those dogs around when I was little, it helped.
Got her a hamster. The thing is, she got really attached to him. When he died, she cried for days. Sarah, I hear you. I just can't see going through all that pain again.
Now, Kayla, I expect you to demonstrate some maturity, okay? I just want to help this
what
animal.
What do we do?
So just let me have him,
I
okay?
need your help. Have some fun.
I don't want to hurt you or the dog. Just let me have him.
Open it.
Get away. Help! 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 Help!
What is this, my dog? They don't do anything for you. They're harmless. They're babies. What? Did you have to scare them? You scared them. Look at your face.
Hey, Tony, call the police. This moron is trespassing.
Mr. Fairmont, I came down as soon as bus security called me.
We just saw Kayla a couple hours ago down those tracks.
Right. We think she was just at the Agua Dulce salvage yards. I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but they got a guy down there who was after the dog. Come on.
You know, I was almost killed. Now, I say we call it even, Stephen. You forget about this whole trespassing thing, and I promise I won't sue for being attacked. What do you say? Oh, no.
Officer, thank God you're here. You won't believe what just happened to me. Sarah, wait till I tell you this.
Dr. David Ortero.
Yes, officer. Let me have a moment with my partner, please.
Hands Ow. Behind your head, please.
Excuse me?
Hands behind your head. Do
what?
It.
I don't understand. What's going on?
You're under arrest.
Officer, I was
You're
bitten
under arrest.
What for?
Assault.
Assault. You're absurd. All right, this was an accident here.
Kayla!
It was a tranquilizer pistol. Sarah, tell him, please.
You left us.
It was absolutely absurd.
Where's Kayla?
I don't know. She went off with the dog.
Which way did she go?
I don't know. I was too busy being mauled by those animals.
All right, come on.
Please. You know, I know Commissioner Scoven.
Yeah.
I'll have you arrested in an hour.
She can't have gone far.
Smell a lake. It's pretty around here, Kayla.
Listen, my child, you say to me, I am the voice of your history.
step here, Kayla. You get out first, and I'll jump. Guy's got a mate here.
Hey, new guy. Listen, come here. Come on.
Fabulous.
Welcome aboard. You're going to love it here, man. You got all the food you can eat.
You don't
all day long to run around. Man, you're going to love it. It's heaven on earth. We got medical for life. No fleas. No ticks.
3 squares a day. And they groom us once a week.
3 meals a day and medical insurance. Shoo. Can you believe it, Kayla? This place is heaven on earth.
I'm gonna ask where all the dulce is from here. Okay, Magic? Just stay here.
Okay.
Excuse me? Miss, please stop.
I'm just gonna sniff around a little bit, Kayla. I'll be right here.
Monsieur, I beg your pardon, s'il vous plaît. Can you tell me what you're doing so boldly in the bath section on Ladies' Day? Boys are not permitted.
Excuse me, mademoiselle. I didn't know.
Oh, please. I'm so tired of hearing that line. Can't you come up with something fresh?
I don't live here, miss.
So then what are you doing here if you don't live here?
Just taking a shortcut.
A shortcut? To where?
Well, it's kind of complex.
Oh, no. Get back. I'm still in the bath, miss.
Oh, forgive me.
Wait a minute. You're a stray, aren't you?
Well, not really. You see, I'm with that little girl over there.
Oh, you're so lucky, monsieur. How I love the children. They're so wonderful to be around.
They sure are. A real gift.
Is it possible she can take me to...
Jack! Would you mind terribly putting your nosy inquiries to rest, my dear?
Well, I never. How dare you?
Never is absolutely correct. You never listen. That's your trouble.
I'm gonna stretch my legs a bit.
And I think you listen too much to things that are none of your... Oh, monsieur, wait. Where are you going?
I'm just gonna go lie out for a second.
He's trying not to get his ears chewed off, if it isn't at all obvious to you, mademoiselle.
What's obvious to me is your rudeness. You know how I love children.
Yes. We're all acutely aware of your love for children, Lola. And I've told you, your chance will come to live with a family and be best friends with a child, but only if you keep your faith.
Yes, I will keep my faith.
Remember, some things are not in our hands.
Scratch me there, please. Thank you. Oh, a child and a family.
Atta girl. Now just go back to being pretty.
Agua Dulce. I'm going to see my mom there. Can you show me which way it is?
Yes, no matter how much I tell Lola, we're not supposed to talk about who we are and why we're sent here. She forgets and blabs away. She wants to know what it's like to get her wings. Like the ones you have.
How do you know?
Come off it, mate. It's not hard to spot a guardian angel.
Very good, my friend. Have we met before?
We may be given a new name and body, but I never forget a soul. We were sky mates, up there. Now I'm waiting for my wings.
Yes. Winston.
I want an assignment, a young life to help.
Sure, you're gonna go down here and turn the corner, and it's about 2 miles up the road, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Yep.
Magic!
I'm over here, Kayla, by the fountain.
Magic!
Be right there, Kayla. Coming. Well, I guess this is it. Good luck on your wings, old buddy. And Lola's, too.
Magic. Smashing fellow.
What's happening?
No
great. We have a flat.
A flat? How do you know we have a flat?
It's my car. I know we have a flat.
Okay, great. But you're not driving your car. I'm driving your car. How do you know it's a flat?
Look at this. No reception. Let me have your phone. I have to call Davis.
Okay, Detective Davis, I can help you change a flat tire.
But he knows where Kayla is.
Look, I'm just going to pull over.
Kayla tried to warn me about you last night. I thought it was just her wild imagination.
Dad, I had no idea about any of this until today.
Yeah, what about Ortero? He seemed to know.
Well, he must have gone over my head and somehow manipulated Dr. Haas.
Haas? Who's Haas?
He runs Genevet. Look, I knew my position was complicated, but I had no idea of the politics.
Is it true you killed all those dogs?
When there is no hope left, sometimes putting a dog to sleep is the only solution to its suffering.
Yeah, what about this animal, huh? What about him? Is there any hope for him?
Yes. Yes, Brad, there's hope. This dog is a miracle.
Miracle. Miracle because cell phone reception, right? Thanks.
So could you give me some more coffee, please?
Sure thing.
Thanks.
Maybe we should come back later.
That's what you came here for, Kayla.
But this isn't the right time.
She's sitting right there.
She's busy.
Kayla.
Come on.
You'll never forgive yourself if you don't find out.
Magic, no!
Oh, hello. My goodness. What a big boy you are. Where did you come from? Is this your dog? What's his name?
Magic.
Magic. Oh, well, that is a perfectly wonderful name, isn't it? Yes.
Kayla.
Oh.
We experimented on the dog using a new drug that we implanted, and it wasn't working. So I put the dog to sleep using sodium pentobarbital.
Did he expire?
He flatlined, Brad.
Where was Ortero?
He was in the bathroom.
Had he seen you put the dog down?
Of course, he assisted me. He saw the dog die, and when he came back, the dog was alive. And I see that as a miracle.
And Ortero, what did he think?
Well, he thought that the catheter was effective and that the dog didn't get the full dose.
To be honest with you, Sarah, that's a little more my side of the fence.
He was gone for 7 minutes. He had no vitals, and now he's fine.
When you say fine, what about his illness?
What I just described to you happened 3 weeks ago. He's been in remission ever since. He's cured.
So the drug worked.
That's what David thinks.
So do you live around here?
Kinda. Not exactly.
Honey, is there something wrong?
Yes, I...
What have you got there? Is it of me? I heard they did an article. Can I see it? Oh, and they used an old photograph. I don't know why my publicist keeps doing that.
Your real name is Amanda Francis.
That's right, yes. I changed it when I did my first play in New York.
My mother's maiden name is Francis.
How about that? It's a coincidence, huh?
You don't know who I am, do you?
Why, have we met?
You can't tell by just looking at me? My eyes, see? They're exactly like yours. And the chin. I even had blonde hair like you when I was little. You don't remember me, do you?
I don't have any children. I hope to someday, but I haven't had any yet. I tell you, if I do, and it's a little girl, I hope she's just like you.
How did you come by the dog?
Found him at the pound, and I adopted him. He was really sick, so I thought there might be a slim chance we could cure him.
You adopted a dog to use him for research?
I convinced Genevieve to at least let me experiment on a sick dog. If I hadn't done that, David would have found a healthy dog to experiment on.
How do you experiment on a healthy animal?
Easy. You create the disease. Something I swore I would never do again. I have a question for you.
What?
When we were at your house, in your attic searching, there was a box that you said it contained your wife's belongings. That doesn't sound like divorce to me.
She's been dead 7 years.
And why does Kayla think that she's still gonna see her mother?
She's in denial. I tried talking to her, but she has trouble catching her breath. She hyperventilates. She thinks her mom's coming back, even though I keep all her things hidden away.
Not all of her things. Look, I'm sure I'm way out of line here, but 7 years? That's a long time to still be wearing your wedding ring. Maybe Kayla's denial is coming from your own.
Hello. They found her.
Do you have a phone? I guess I should call my dad.
Well, he is probably on his way by now.
You called somebody?
The assistant director called the police about 15 minutes ago, and they were going to track down your dad.
The police? No! I have to talk to him first.
Okay, sweetie, we can make that happen. It's okay.
No, you don't understand. They're going to kill Magic.
Kayla, calm down.
We have to get out of here. Magic!
Kayla! Jeff!
Kayla!
No, Kayla.
Kayla!
It's time to give him a chance, Kayla.
Kayla, stop! That's enough. Come here, baby. Oh, honey. Honey, honey, honey.
Oh. Keep her away from Magic, Dad.
Take it easy.
No, I told you, they're gonna cut him up.
No, honey. That's my partner, Dr. Ortero, not me. I'm trying to stop him.
I don't believe you. Daddy, please. I know this is going to sound really weird, but Magic is special. He can talk. Words and everything, just like you and me.
He can talk?
Yes, and he's really smart, too. See, look at the stitches. They cut his throat up before. That's why they want to do it now. They want to see why he can talk.
Honey, Dr. Westcott, she told me all about Magic. He's special. He's really special, but not because he could talk. Those stitches on his throat, that's from an operation that Sarah did. He was very sick. He had throat cancer.
Cancer?
It's okay. Sarah put an implant in. She's curing him.
We are very, very excited about him.
No. That's not it. She's lying.
Honey, take it easy.
He really can't. I'm not making it up, I swear. Show him magic. Show him you can talk. Come on. It'll be okay. I know you probably didn't want anyone to hear you except me. But you have to. Please, magic. You can show my dad. Please. Talk. Please, talk.
Come here, boy.
Magic, no!
Good boy.
He did, Dad. I swear he did.
We've had a long day, honey. Let's go get some rest, okay? I wanted to talk to you about your mom.
Dad. It's okay. I know what happened to Mom. And I never really believed the other stuff. That actress. The dog. I knew it was all pretend. I know there's no such thing as magic.
Dogs and autumn leaves and BB guns. God didn't make little green apples, and it don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime. And when myself is feeling low, I think about her face aglow to ease my mind.
Thank you again for letting us come.
You're welcome, honey.
Dr. Westcott, I need you to step outside with me.
Taking the dog, Sarah.
Okay, no, Dr. Haas said that nothing would happen to the dog until I had a chance to finish my proposal.
It no longer matters what Dr. Haas says. The Genovet Board of Directors is in total agreement with me.
Board of Directors.
You never did get it, did you, Sarah? Our primary purpose is to publish research in medical journals. That's how we get the funding for more research. I mean, if we happen to find a cure, well, then whoopsie daisy. But then we don't know if there'll be a relapse or secondary complications. And then the non-extrapolation when it goes to human trials, all of which could take years. And not to mention other researchers around the world who are this close to what we stumble upon. No, by dissecting this dog, we'll have something to publish. Publish or perish, Sarah. Being first, that's our bread and butter. Now, what you suggest could take years. And significantly lower Genovet's stock in the process.
You convinced them that their company's stock would drop if we waited to see what happened to the dog. You used a fear tactic.
Don't be naive, Sarah. The whole world runs on fear. Take the dog.
No.
Just take the dog.
No.
Come on. Take the dog.
No.
Don't touch the dog. Don't.
Excuse me?
Touch the dog. Nobody touches the dog.
This dog is
take
not
the
Genovet's
dog, please.
Property. This is not Genovet's
please.
Property.
Sir, I don't know who you think you are. Just
look,
take
the moment no. Sarah rescued the dog from the pound, he became her property.
Excuse me. Take the dog, please. Sir, you're delusional, all right? This is Genovet's property.
No, you can't!
Listen, you're a very sweet girl. Now, you just go with your daddy here. Leave this to the professionals,
please.
The dog
is no longer Genovet's property. We filed an ex parte app in court. The judge agreed. We won. That's a TRO. You can't touch magic. Now, if you want to pursue this, it's going to cost Genevieve a lot, and I don't mean just money.
You think they care? Yes. Okay.
If I were you, I'd take rent a cop here and just go.
Well, touche. Very good. I'll be back. Trust that.
I don't think so.
Oh, I know so. I know so. I'm fine. Get away from me. I'm fine. I can do it myself.
Thank you, Daddy. How long has it been?
A couple hours, almost.
Dad?
Hmm?
You know that pendant? The one you said I could have? If it's all right, I think I want it.
It's been right here, honey, waiting for you.
Beautiful.
She was beautiful. Almost as beautiful as you.
He came through just fine.
Thank God.
Yes.
It was tough there for a moment, but he's a real trooper.
That is great.
Do you want to go see him?
Can I?
Sure, go ahead. Thank you for everything you did for magic.
You're welcome.
Listen, I heard about that big merger being pulled from your firm. I'm so sorry. I know it's a lot of money.
There's nothing. They can keep their money.
Told me I know the truth about my mom. And you were right. The whole time you were right. It just wasn't the truth I wanted to hear. I love you.
I love you too, Kayla.
You know, I was hoping there'd be someone around to help me get him back into shape. They always seem to heal so much quicker when there's someone around to mother him.
Really? Can I, Dad?
Is that an official prescription?
Why, yes, it is.
No, I can't ignore doctor's orders.
Thanks, Dad.
It's doing good.
Things have been kind of dead lately. What with the kid being back in school? Little troll. Looks at me and says, aren't you a little old to be a babysitter? I'm like, no. I mean, talk about a spoiled little princess. Her dad has that blonde doctor chick come over every few days with that huge stupid dog just so they can hang out. I know. Hey, did I tell you that I totally busted them yesterday? Oh, yeah, dude.
lip locked in his Benz in the driveway. I gotta go. Hi.
Hi. Things have sort of changed around here, Tammy. I'm gonna be working at home in the afternoons now.
That's great.
But I won't be needing a babysitter.
Okay.
I didn't ding you for the wine. Consider it severance pay.
I laughed at her when she got mad. The first day that she met her was just a twig. Then the first snow came and she ran out to brush the snow away. So it wouldn't die. Came running in, all excited. Slipped and almost hurt herself. And I laughed till I cried. She was always young at heart. Kinda dumb and kinda smart. And I loved her so. And I surprised her with a puppy. Kept me up all Christmas Eve. 2 years ago. And it would sure embarrass her when I came in from working late, 'cause I would know that she'd been sitting there crying over some sad and silly late, late show. And honey, I miss you. And I'm being good. And I'd love to be with you, if only I could.
Did you say?
Merry Christmas.
Thank
you.
Well, where is that beautiful lady that you have engaged yourself to? I haven't met her. I haven't seen her. Where is she?
How did you hear about that?
Well, I hear she's beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
Yes?
Yeah, she's here.
Well, please, bring her over.
Let me find her.
Okay.
Merry Christmas and congratulations!